Today we are going to talk about access, and we're gonna give you an introduction to what the program is. We know databases are everywhere we go, so might as well get used to them. Let's open an existing database. If you notice, I am in the file tab, and I'm going to use student database. An object in access is a main component that is created and used to make the database function. A field is the smallest data element contained in a table. For instance, here the first name is a field, the last name is another field. A record is a complete set of all the data elements or fields about one person, place, event, or concept. That is, this entire row is basically a record. This whole collection of records is what's called a table. A table, the foundation of every database, is a collection of related records. And a database consists of one or more tables to store data, one or more forms to enter data into the table, and one or more reports to output the table data as organized information. We have four tabs at the ribbon. The home tab, create external data, and database tools. You notice at the top it says student database, which is the name of my file, and the format is Access 2007. If you remember, I said after 2007 the extension of the file is followed by an X. In this case, Access will be an MDB, which is Microsoft Database. That's the extension of an Access file. And a 2007 will be MDBX. To the left, we have the navigation pane, which organizes and lists the database objects in the Access database. If we click on the tables, we can collapse and expand all the tables in this database. Same thing for queries, forms, reports, macros. We will talk about them at the end of the Excel book. And you notice here I have some information that is missing, but it's not required. For instance, the room. Now, this at the top you will see is my student list. This is my list of students. You notice I double click on the students table, and I will explain to you what each of these fields do. You notice I open, when I double click on the table, it opens the table for editing. That means I can start entering data straight to the table. It is not a nice way to enter data. It is preferable you enter in a form. For instance, this is a form, which here populates the data inside the table. Let's go over some of the components of the ribbon. In Home tab, we can design a database. For instance, on my table, I can change the view to design, or can change it to data view. What's the difference? In the data sheet view, I can enter the data straight to the table. In the design view, I am creating fields, modifying fields, adding or deleting fields of one table. We click on the pivot table and the pivot chart. We will explain those once we get to Excel. For now, we're going to skip them. And let's go back to students table. We are now working with the table's views. Remember, the datasheet view is where you add, edit, or delete the records of a table, and the design view is where you create tables, add and delete fields, or modify field properties. Now let's go to the design view. You will notice here's the field names and here's the data type of the field. For instance, the ID is a number, it's a numeric value. I cannot have any characters. Last name, first name, email address, those are free text. The date of birth is a date. And the rest of the fields are text. A web page is a hyperlink. And here, if you notice, when you click on the data type column, a list of all the different types show up. We're going to be focusing on the most common ones, which are the text, number, currency, date, time, yes or no, and in the beginning of the table we notice that the ID is as auto number, it's not simply a number, which means it's auto populated. And you notice there's a key next to it, and this button is highlighted, which is the primary key. Primary key is a field or combination of fields that uniquely identifies each record in a table. That means there cannot be another record within that table with the exact same primary key. Now, if we focus on the last name, which is a text, we tell it it can hold up to 50 characters. And there are other attributes or field properties, you notice here, that we can change. We'll go into details of each one of them in class. Now, if we go back to the data sheet view, you will notice the ID table is highlighted column and disregard that click. And I can enter another one here. For instance, I can say on, and you'll notice here this little pencil. Pencil in record selector indicates the record that's being edited. So that means the whole record is being edited, the number 2. And you notice I did not have to type number 2, it was automatically highlight enter it for me. And so forth, the rest of the fields. Now I finish entering. Now I have 2 records on my table. You notice at the bottom of the screen there's the navigation buttons. First one makes you go to the first record. The second one makes you go to the previous record. Tells you how many records, the current record being shown, which is one, number 1. If I click on number 2 here, it'll change to number 2. The next arrow takes you to the next record. This takes you to the last record. If you click this one, it will add a new record at the bottom, which will be the 3rd one. There's no filter selected, and we can have a search. For instance, I will say word grade, and it found it for me. That's it. We're going to continue in the next video with use of forms, queries, and reports.